All right, time for round two versus Brad, who was defeated round one by Tom Martell. I would still like to play first. And I certainly can't mulligan that. I will go ahead and keep that. All right, and a few minutes later, Brad shows up. He was not aware that we got to battle more after losing round one, so I had to call him. This hand works out quite well. That or losing to Martell just completely demoralized him. I mean, he did lose to Martell after all. Alright, Perilous Mirror. I could battle his guy, but then I'd be trading one for two. I'll just pass. Don't really want to clasp his dude either. I suppose I could go for a land here. I think I found what I'm going to clasp. No reason to let him get value out of his Riddlesmith. See, Perilous Mirror is awesome. He doesn't even want to trade one for one for it, but at some point he's going to have to. Unless he waits till too late, then the Barrage Jugger comes out. Yee. That's kind of unfortunate. Alright, well, I guess that gives us a way to kill his Sphinx. Might as well play this now, for now, though. Yeah, he smashes for four. If we draw any land, we can go Sensor Bolt his guy. Assuming he doesn't play three artifacts this turn. Ooh, geez, Nim Deathmantle. Alright, well. Land would have been good there, I have to admit. Since the turn to Slag might be a little slow to. Although it does get rid of the Nim Deathmantle quite effectively. Of course, now I don't know what I'm going to do about Argent Sphinx. I mean, assuming he's got another artifact. Alright, maybe he does not have an artifact. I think I just take it here. I could block the Shikari with the mirror and blow up his mirror, but I really want to make sure I can kill his Sphinx this turn. Of course, then I draw the land for it, but that's okay. And bash for four. Next turn, if he attacks with, or when he attacks with the Shikari, I think I do want to block with the Perilous Mirror. Of course, he does get to bring his Silver Mirror back to life, but I think that's okay. Waste his whole turn. Nope, he does not feel like spending that mana. Alright. Land would be pretty good here. Ding. Turn to Slag is a pretty nice card, I have to admit. Then battle for two, since I'd rather just trade Oriok Replica for Snap Cell Glider. And now I have a handful of sweet 5-drops. Also have Clasp Sensor if the game goes long. Which the 5-drops in my hand probably make unlikely. Yeah. Of course, he's on 4 lands, so he's got a lot of spells in his hand. get a barrage ogre out there. And keep battling for two with the Sky Guard. Disperse. Interesting. Alright, I suppose that's not that big of a deal. Unless he has like a barbed battle gear or something. Alright, well, we're turning that to slag. Let me tell you that. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, I think I'd rather hold my guy back. Hope he doesn't have equipment. That could be awkward. And it was awkward. Alright. Though I'm not killing him anytime soon, so. This is kind of tough. 3-3 first strike is pretty tough to deal with. I think we play the artisan here. Next turn, artisan can block his guy successfully. Hopefully he doesn't have a 4 power guy to put the strider harness onto. Alright, things are not looking so great here. Let's see. Oh no, it's a barrage. Alright. This isn't the worst, actually. The Golem Artisan can kind of take over this game now. If he attacks with the Skyo School, I can jump the replica, double block, and then pump replica. So I trade one of my guys for his guy. And the addition of the Shikaris doesn't really change that much. And if he doesn't do anything, he gets proliferate. Of course, it does mean I'm kind of stuck keeping mana up. Yeah, because if I play... Let's see what happens if I play Barrage Ogre. That's actually not that bad. Worst comes to worst, I can just use Oriok replica to block one and then sack it. Nope, don't want to give plus and plus one. Definitely want to give flying. Fine. I still think this is worth it, even though I lose both my guys, because if I sit there and don't play my spells and he just plays like another creature, it becomes a lot worse for me. And now that I have Barrage Ogre out, I have a lot more control of the situation. Chrome Steed is good. Still shipping the turn though. I think I like the board position, despite me being at 1 and him being at 15. Slowly burning him out here. Alright, now it's time for the beatdowns. Alright. Guess he didn't really have anything. I wasn't drawing much either, though. White, blue, a lot of equipment. Playing all my removal already. don't see a whole lot I can sideboard in here. And I guess that's that.